guys, welcome back to How to Repair Guys. If you guys have a vehicle such as Ford Edge guys or any Ford guys and your steering wheel vibrates really bad when you're going at higher speeds, you hit the brake, okay, you apply brake and your steering wheel starts vibrating at higher speeds, guys, we'll explain what causes that. It is known as steering wheel brake pulsation, guys. Okay, it's caused by uneven rollers, okay, rollers that are uneven and you cannot catch that with your bare eye in most of the cases, guys, so we'll show you how to fix it and what causes that. Stay with us and we'll continue. In the meantime, guys, we'll have more than 200 videos on every vehicle we get at the shop because our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. Please subscribe to the channel, like and drop a comment below, guys, with your recommendations. So, let's start on it now. So the car is in the air, jacked up, guys. We're ready to go ahead and remove the wheel now. Okay, so we're just removing the tire now. Perfect. Okay, guys, and that's what we have here now. So, now guys, we turn the steering wheel to the right, that way we can access the bolts for the brake caliper here. So we're using, guys, that Interphone spray. It's really good penetrating spray. And we're going to spray, okay, between the roller and the hub, so that way it can come off way easier later. So we need, guys, a 17mm socket now. And we're going to remove two bolts that hold that brake caliper to the mount. Okay, this one is really, really tight. You have to be careful not to break your bleeder valve there. So we'll get a little bit bigger tooth because obviously this one hasn't been removed for a while. We have the torque specs and all that on the channel, guys. Okay, whoever installed those, that's just ridiculous tight, guys. It shouldn't be that way, okay? Perfect. Okay, came loose now, finally. One bolt with the glide. Okay, you can see what it looks like. We're going to put them on the napkin. Removing the second one now. Hold your caliper with one hand. Okay, this is the second bolt. Okay, one is shorter than the other one. Check this thing out. The top one is longer bolt. Now, you need to grab your caliper, guys. You need to get some wire or a heavy duty, super heavy duty zip tie. We're going to tie it to the strut there. And then we'll tie the caliper so that way it's not hanging on the brake line. Because if it's hanging on the brake line, you're going to, there is a chance to cause damage to it and lose your brakes later. So you have to be extremely careful, guys. So those are, guys, the brake pads. Okay, got them out. And this is the other one, right there. So, now, what else we need to do? Now, in order, guys, to remove disc roller, we have to remove that bracket here because it's holding it. So that's what we'll be doing next. Okay, 19mm socket. And we have two bolts that we need to get loose. Okay, perfect. Getting those loose now. Okay, we're going to get the caliper bracket here, pull it out. Now that we spray the roller, it even came out super easy, guys, it's not stuck. And just gently pull it out. So this is, guys, the roller. Now what is causing that brake pulsation? Okay, steering wheel pulsation when you hit the brakes going higher speed. The roller is uneven. Okay, you can see this is a low spot, guys. This is a high spot here, low spot. So when you hit that brake, okay, the brake pad will jump from the high to the low spot and it will start bouncing. And that bouncing, okay, goes to the steering wheel and you can definitely feel it, your steering wheel moving. You'll be able to feel that. The higher speed, the higher the pulsation usually. I've noticed on some that are really bad, you can feel it at lower speeds, but usually at about 55 miles per hour and up, okay, you can definitely feel it. So we'll take that one now to the parts store, guys, here next to us, or a machine shop, and they're going to resurface the roller. Okay, they cut the top layer off of it, make it smooth. They check the thickness, because if the roller is too thin, they will not be able to resurface it, because they will cut a very thin layer out of it. So they check the thickness, make sure that it's in specs, and they will resurface it, and it's very inexpensive. So we received, guys, the roller from the parts store. Okay, you can see how nice and smooth now it is. We don't have any low and high spots. The guy said that we had a little bit of an even place on one side, the front. They resurfaced as well, so that was what was causing our brake and steering wheel pulsation. So we'll go ahead and put it together now. So now, guys, we'll be using the brake caliper compressor tool. This is for a single piston, guys, but we'll show you guys how it works. Okay, now we're going to use a brake parts cleaner here, guys, and we're going to clean the rubber seals to make sure that there is no dust and stuff like that, because what will happen now when we compress it, guys, those pistons will go inside, and you want to make sure that this rubber seals are actually, guys, okay, clean and not contaminated with dust, because later that dust, okay, can develop, guys, leaks, okay, and sticking pistons and all that stuff. So we'll be using the old, okay, old brake pad here, guys. This is the two set that we'll be using. Old brake pad, we'll place it like that. Okay, we'll show you in a second. Now we're going to get one of the compressors. Okay, this is for a single caliper tool, but it will work in our case as well. And we'll use, okay, that plate here now as well. We'll show you in a second. Okay, like that. We'll go ahead. Screw it like that until it starts compressing. And now you're going to notice, guys, how when we turn, it's going to compress both pistons. So it's a little bit harder because we're compressing two pistons, but it's working, you can see. Okay, this is it, perfect. You have to stand till the end because there is a trick that we'll be using now. Otherwise, guys, you may crash your car the first time you start it after you put new brakes. So from that point on, guys, putting it together is in reverse order. We took it apart, we'll put it together, we're going to test drive it and let you know, guys, if that fixes the problem. So make sure you stand till the end. If you want to see the whole video, putting it together, torque specs for the brake caliper and all that stuff, it's on the channel, guys, so please check it out. So we put, guys, everything together. You can see pretty much in reverse order we took it apart. If you want to see the procedure, we have the complete guide how to replace the brake pads and torque specs and all that stuff. It's on the channel. Now what we need to do, we need to go inside, guys, because when you put new pads, you know, you compress the pistons, so you will have some play here, and the first few times you hit your brake pad or your brakes may not work. So you want to, guys, make sure you go in the car now, pump the brake pedal at least 20 times to feel nice. Then when you put your car together in while it's in park and with the emergency brake on, pump the pedal until it feels good, the brakes feel good, because otherwise you put it in drive or reverse and your brakes don't work, you can crash your car or kill somebody that's around you. So be careful when you do that, guys. Okay, and we keep pumping the brake pedal, guys. Pump it at least 20 times to make sure it feels good. So we're inside now, guys. We have a person inside pumping the brake pedal. Okay, I can definitely see a little bit of movement and we don't have any more play. Okay, guys, so that we're going to go ahead and test it now and see how the steering wheel feels. So after driving the car, guys, on the highway, absolutely zero vibration, highway speed. I even went to 75, 80 mile an hour, hit the brake, and there was absolutely no vibration and pulsation in the steering wheel. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Fix that problem. Thank you for watching, guys, and see you guys next time.